Link Up TV. My name is Emma Vonsell, and this week on The Listening Party, we are reviewing a highly anticipated album. It's J Hus's Big Conspiracy. Right, what are our like thoughts on J Hus currently?
Oh, he's the GOAT.
Yeah, he's the GOAT.
He's actually the GOAT. I feel
just
like
just a bad boy.
He is someone that is really the embodiment of what a musician is.
Everybody look like a secret agent, so I say no to drugs like Ronald Reagan. Talking shit, you don't think first when you say things. You weren't the same when I bucked him on that occasion. There's no law, how can I be law-abiding? He's still deciding whether he's riding. The world is small, so it's not hard to find him. Nothing in this dunya is satisfying. All these niggas selling now, but nobody's buying.
His tone of voice, yeah?
Cadence and that's just cold.
Yeah, brings you into what he's saying as well, because sometimes it might sound a bit basic what he's saying, but the way he's saying it pumps it up a bit.
Do you reckon it's that basic?
It's not basic.
Bro, but
what he's saying,
occasion
what
he's and version and I invasion.
I hear what you're saying.
Bro, that's rhyming.
No,
that's
but I'm saying like
it is, man. Like,
that's his style. He's got adult rhyming pattern and he makes it easy. He makes it easy for everybody to follow. It's not like no mumble rap. You can hear every word he says. And the way he sets up his rhymes for them to come in, it's easy listening. It's for every, it's not alienating nobody. You can all get with it and take it
but
in.
I'm saying,
and that's a skill.
If certain people
in
are
its
saying,
own.
Yeah, it's a skill in its own.
Right.
But that's
right.
What I'm rating.
Right.
But
that's what, yeah.
It's such a basic rhyming pattern. But because of his tone of voice and the way he drops it and so smooth, he's always done it. J Hus has always done it.
I understand the kind of thought that goes into the writing process, and I know what he's doing. So my man's whole flow, tone of his voice, the way he's saying things, the accent he's using on things and all that, it goes into the whole musical process. Do you get what I'm trying to say? That so he's doing it and he's written them, he's done it on purpose. He ain't alienated no one, like anybody can listen to it. The diction's there, it's all clear, you can all follow along, and that in itself is an art.
Shaitan in police uniform, feds in the helicopter. I see pigs fly, but I never seen a unicorn. Trying to find.
That Nada agrees with you. Our man didn't say nothing. Because he's J Hus and the way he said it, it's cold, fam. Because what did he even say? He's dirty, bro.
Yeah. He's a shaitan as a police
uniform. Yeah, but you see, bro, man said three things and man want to wheel it already. That's what Hus does. Bro, is it. You might have said it the way you said it, people don't get it, but I get what you're saying, innit? And it's you're not taking it away from him, you're giving it to him.
No, definitely not, bro.
It's like, he can say something normal, because he's Hus, it's like, oh, shit.
And the way he says it.
Yeah, like, it's the delivery, like, yeah, it's the delivery, yeah, bro. Just everything, yeah,
it's like,
yeah.
Bro, you're
it's
like,
too smooth, it's too man, smooth.
All he said was it's police uniform, like.
Yeah, it's too smooth,
so,
though.
A drill you saying, I fucking say that every fucking track.
Yeah. It wouldn't have been cold if
it's
it wasn't.
It's the play on words, the shaitan is calling a man there the devil in the police uniform. Yeah. The tune's called Helicopter, he said, I've seen pigs fly. You know the police do helicopter things. It's like, it's not like, it's not super duper basic. It's, if you know what he's saying and the way the words are connecting and that, it's cold, bro.
I think. If you're just looking at the lyrics, you might think it's basic, but when you kind of get a deeper understanding, you realise that he's actually doing a lot without even
Can I cut that word out that I said basic? It's just the way I talk. I don't mean that everyone can do it. I mean, it's just A, B, C. But the way he's put it out is totally different.
I'm having the money, I'm being a hustler. I carry the fire for an imposter, you know.
If my son listens to sister now, yeah.
His sister,
yeah.
Use knowledge and wisdom in this Babylon system, but the swami was a victim.
What I appreciate so much, going back to Malika's point about it sounds grown and mature, it's such a political statement, and a lot of what he's saying is like you can tell that J Hus has been through almost like an enlightenment journey into like knowledge and understanding, and that's coming through in his lyrics and
his Twitter.
And
it comes through his Twitter.
He does talk a lot about just like the mental, spiritual aspects of life. I remember him tweeting about the soles of your feet and what the soles of your feet mean. It's just like to know that you are doing some research, and I appreciate that. So I feel like as he is taking in new information, he's just spitting it out there, and as he grows on, he'll give it to us in a way that is more digestible. Some people get it, some people don't, but I appreciate it, and I get it. I love it.
How you gonna run the world? You can't even run your life. I'm destiny's child, every day I survive. No time to plan out to improvise. If you was real, you'll recognize.
How do you sleep at night when you don't even fight for your right? How do you sleep at night when you never even fight for your right? We run from Rollies with the Mulianis. They can't see my face, I'm like a hijabi. I got a stack of bread, cut, I'm building my army. You know I'm so solid, they're calling me Harvey.
No!
I get all the Usna and all of the nannies.
No!
What? Don't be guessing, it's the same thing he's been doing the whole time. You call it basic.
No!
Yeah.
But do you catch what I'm saying? You see how he's flipped it now?
You know
what
I hear you? It's like Idi Amin. Remember
Idi
Amin? It's like Idi Amin. I can't even say Idi Amin. I can't even say it normal no more. It's Idi Amin. Idi Amin.
Yeah!
He's not Idi Amin, Idi Amin.
Still in my jeans.
Yeah!
Still in my jeans. I don't even call them jeans,
that's
or jeans.
That's my point, bro.
I'm putting some jeans.
I'm not saying
jeans now. I don't give a fuck.
What he's saying,
bro, he's the waviest character of all time.
He can just get you like that.
Bro, he's too wavy, fam.
And your mumble vibe.
He's just a wave, man. He's just there, like. Just with everyone else, bro. That's like, Idi Amin.
Yeah.
Yo, play that, man. Basic is the wrong word, because basic kind of means like the bare minimum, like doing what you just have to do. I think the word simple is a better use of words. Something can be simple, but still quality. And I think that is Jay Huss.
I'll get all the Usna and all of the nannies. I might make a baby and breed me a Barbie.
Hey, like Nikki, my like lyric. Cardi.
You might see me and Riri in a Rari.
Hey.
I'm giving the orders. How can my man overcharge us? I had to finesse, I've done a koalas.
Ah.
I don't ever rest, that's why I'm the hardest. Get the bread, avoid the drama.
Trust
you can avoid the feds, but not the karma.
Ah,
protect your chest with body armor.
Yeah.
And get the llama from the farmer.
I ain't run the world, you can't even run your life.
Jay Huss is top tier, top of the line, the best of the best, in his own lane. No one can touch him. He is the epitome of what a goat is.
They highly respect violence.
I wheel it already. Wheel it already. Wheel it already. Wheel it already. J5. Yeah, back.
When I listen to Jay Huss, like, the thing I just love is, like, I can imagine this live. And I feel like a lot of the time we listen to, like, a lot of music, like all different types of genres, especially when people are rapping, and I'm like, okay, cool, it's all right. But when I come and see you live, it's going to be you with a mic, and I'm not engaged, like, properly. I can just picture the whole... Yeah. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's just so musical. It's just, crazy, like, how can I not appreciate it?
He's worked on his craft, and it's dope. And that's what I'm trying to say, like, because he's worked on it so much, yeah, and obviously, like I'm saying, the rhyming pattern that he's got and the way he set everybody up just to be able to listen to him and take him in and hear everything clearly. Yeah. Man kind of take it for granted and think it's simple and easy things that he's doing, but it's not. No. And the production on the tape so far has been cold as well.
There's certain artists, yeah, that I can't particularly fuck with because it's just, it's too complex, innit? When I'm listening to music, I just want to vibe and bounce. Mm. And for me, Huss, especially as a UK artist, he's got the perfect balance when it comes to the depth and the wave. Because if you listen to what he's saying, it's deep. But you can also sign out and just bounce.
The way he's saying it's cold, the flow's cold, there's content in there. He's not just putting words together for the sake of it. He's saying stuff.
I think Jay Huss, like, not even to take, like, again, not to switch up the convo, but I think Jay Huss is a very good reflection of where the UK scene is at the moment, innit? He's very advanced, innit? The quality of music he's providing to be a step ahead of everyone else, because that's what I think he is. It's actually amazing. Like, there's a couple man that's amazing, but for me, Jay Huss just stands out. He's just so unique. You could never. I know we got that Par Salut Ute just come true from Coventry, and everyone went crazy. And oh, he sounds like, you might have even heard it. He's a Ute. He sounds like Jay Huss a lot. But my thing is, you need to be prepared for that, innit? Because Jay Huss is he's like an originator of a new sound, and there's gonna be Utes that catch on, and I have no issue with that. He's a real.
Is he originator of a new sound? Is that fair to say?
I think he is, because I think he's made a lot of people try and use the accent, because you know you can hear the African accent in the flow. You get what I'm saying? I think he's made a lot of people do that and feel comfortable to do that.
It's new to the UK. It's not new in life, because Jay Huss is influenced by people, and I'm sure he could tell you who. But with all his influences rounded into this one character, it's a brand new machine.
Right, we're gonna go over to this side quickly. What were you gonna say?
See, but I feel like he's just mad composed, like everything. Yeah, he's so elite, bro. Like anything that he does, anything he puts out, regardless of what it is, it's composed.
Let's not forget though, when Jay Huss first started off, he was funny. Like, people thought he was funny, and they kind of didn't take him serious until he
kept it going. I think it's
when he busts, everyone gravitates.
Yeah, like he kept it going, and he was like conversational. He was conversational with his music, and then people started taking him serious.
I personally don't think that Jay Huss is an originator of a new sound, but I do think that he took the sound to a whole nother level, because if you listen to even what Jay Huss says about his music, he credits the people that he was influenced by. So let's not ignore the people that paved the way for Jay Huss. We do this often, we act like people just come out the blue and just become amazing. No, people laid the foundation and he just took that foundation and just grew.
I know you're in love, got me at the mat with the extension. I may have the money for your extensions, coming at your hair longer than my gun.
I will it! Jackie. The bomb clout!
Jackie!
Burner boy is.
Have you heard Huss's verses? He's got all the burners, he's giving the gal.
Bro, burner boy is illegal, it's not allowed.
I know you're in love, got me up the map with the extension. And me up the money for your extension. Coming like your hair longer than my gun.
Listen,
ooh, we have the gun man, girl. If we keep the balance, I'm up in my world. When I sleep in a man, anytime it could go down. She won't hold down, she let it all out. Pow, 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 pow.
My favorite girl had the French braids. I had a crush on her since back a day. She said her usna needs a bandage. I'll come round and give her a 12 gauge.
I don't remember a man moving like Huss before Huss. So I'll give him pioneer status. Rule talk. I don't remember a man moving like that before. I'm not saying niggas weren't rapping and that, but it's just like the whole mix, like man sticking to his roots. He's got like the Afrobeats feel. He's doing the hardcore hip hop thing. He's, you get what I'm trying to say? Like all the sounds and all the elements that he's bringing together are cold.
This time I came with a banana clip.
Got me at the Mac with the extension. I may have the money for the extension. Coming like your hair longer than my gun. Come here, the girls and girls, let me keep the balance. I'm up in my world, we're not sleeping, I'm on.
Hey, stop this. Like, this might be the best tune.
Stop this one sec. This link up is brazy.
No, it's ridiculous. Burner boy, he's so cold. He's too much. He's too much.
He's so cold. This link up is mad.
You see how.
I didn't think he deserved Steph, but he does. No, after that, you deserve everything you get.
No, wait, bam, he's been deserving. Like,
you deserve that.
Don't trigger again if
she's a bad boy.
She's moving like Soulja Boy. Is a Steph?
This can't be the track that makes him deserve Steph. It can't. Burner Boy has been cold.
No, he's been cold.
Wait. Burner Boy has been cold. This isn't like.
Wait, look how you got a hold of my hand.
I'm saying, like, this relax. Burner Boy's been cold. But I'm just saying, you see how we had Burner Boy and some other features? You know when I said it didn't really fit? Well, it didn't sound like, I mean, the other albums listened to. This just sounds like Burner Boy in his element, and then with some Jay Huss. It's like a nice concoction, like it fits so well. Yeah. I could have an album of them two together and enjoy
it.
They need to do that.
For me, they're in the same category.
Head to head first from Hemmer. Yeah.
Burner Boy, Jay Huss, do
that
a joint mixtape.
That will be a madness.
That will be
madness.
Afro Nation for me was the most like, it was just spiritual, and it just seemed like someone that we all loves, just in his element. He's out of jail. He's where he should be. He's given us the vibe and the message that he was brought on this earth for. Like, I really felt like he was living out his purpose. When he's on stage, it makes everyone feel good. You're giving us a message. You're dancing. We're feeling you. And just as a black woman that wants to see black men doing great, I just felt so good in that moment.
I met that gal back in October. Then I gave her the kumba. I'll give you everything you've been urging for. See how Jay Huss make your pum pum so. Come shake your bunda on the dancing floor.
Absolutely.
Your bunda's bigger than when I seen it before.
Hey.
You say you're ready, but do you mean it for sure? I need punani cause I'm fresh from a war.
Hey.
That's why I'm jump back in a car.
My favourite!
Bad man and a soldier.
Shit.
Make her come closer. Then I told her, if I can make it work, then I'm the owner. That girl got high, then she went lower. Says she like dance hard and soca. I'm looking at her neck and I saw a choker. I can make you fall in love with everything I do. But you wanna always bite it.
So glad he's from AC.
I'm not gonna lie, I think this is one of the ones that I skipped, you know.
I like to hear men talk sexually.
I bet you do.
No,
shocking.
Shocking.
New information. You know what I mean? Brand new. Who knew this?
You are right. You are right. The way your waist is moving, and he's talking about he makes your pum pum sore. It's like, I'm just listening. Like,
Jay has to get the gallon wet up.
I didn't know that was a thing. How many gal are there loving their pum pum sore? Like,
no. Okay. I'm just saying that. It's sexy.
The Burna Boy one, I didn't have much to say because that one for me didn't stand out. Like, there's other features I prefer, but this one here.
What was it about?
Straight away. But this, I don't know, like, maybe the music, I'm not sure.
I think it was Pum Pum Soul Bit that got
us. I don't know. It's just like, I feel like his phrasing and like his accent sometimes just stands out on certain songs more than others. Yeah. So this one, and obviously, the sexual content, I'm going to like that compared to the other stuff as well. But
I like to hear rappers talk sexually sometimes just because I feel like it's a side that they don't explore in a way that you can picture it. Some guys will be like, I get a bear girl and I beat them off and that's it. But he's talking a bit more in depth. He's making it sound smooth. It goes with the beat. It's like a whole, it just takes over your whole body. The song takes over your whole body. The lyrics take over your whole body. And it's just nice. You know what I mean? Even if you're not sexual, you're feeling something. You don't know what it is. And it's just making you feel a vibe. We all love a vibe.
I had a big mama 10 years older than me. Hey. One baby, how the body? I like it inside and your outer body. All I do is hustle and count the money. I got a whole army and they all counting on me. I can make it.
This song is so nice. It's just so nice.
Jay Huss's sex appeal goes up by 10.
That's my favourite right there.
All right, cool, let's move on.
I'm super biased. Huss can't do no wrong.
Because obviously, like, he's wavy. He puts things into his lyrics to let you know that he's a conscious youth and he might even study certain things and he understands or even overstands certain things. You know what I'm trying to say? Like, but at the same time, he's, like I said, he's not trying to alienate no one. The wave's there. Everybody can get with it. And when you're writing your lyrics, it's a conscious process that he's done. He's made sure he's included everybody in the process.
Hey, you know how the money thing go. Hey. This ain't better than the Burna Boy thing though, but this is cold though.
For me, it's so much better. I don't know why. Yeah, why?
Where did the money go? This is probably the one I've enjoyed the least.
You're not on a yard man team, man.
Same as me.
Nah, you're an English boy. English boy, cut me boy. You're a top cut me man. I'm Margaret, straight at Ace. Straight out of Ace. And I'm Tricky, straight out of Ace. Fuck you lot. Yeah, you lot voted for Brexit, blood. You voted out. Fuck you, man. British boy.
One sec, guys.
I'm with Margot on this one. I don't think this is the most banging one, but I think it's a very catchy. I think Jay Huss on a whole is catchy as hell, man.
I think this is the biggest, like, it's not the biggest vibe, but it's a big vibe.
I think it's a big vibe just because it's got a little bit of Yardman element on it, though.
No, I'm huffy. Do you know what I like about it? Because we're kind of in this climate where, like, the West Indies and the motherland are just combining so beautifully, like, so this is so necessary, you know what I mean? Like, it's just, Coffee's the up and coming, girl from the islands, Jay Huss is the king of the thing, it's just, it was so necessary.
It's a nice feature, like, everybody was necessary. Could have, like, collaborated.
I'm saying it's dope, I've just been rating the thing up here, and if I was gonna bring it down a notch, this is the first time
this
I would.
This is the reason why it will come down.
This is the first time so far.
For me personally, just listening to the whole album, I'm ready for a switch up in terms of, like, the vibe. It's all been, like, smooth vibes, so I'm ready to get out of my seat and fuck someone up. Like, I wanna just, I'm ready to, like, because you know Jay Huss gives us those type of bangers. Like, I'm ready for that banger, like, now.
My favourite was Coffee. That was my favourite feature on the whole project.
I wear a skull cap like a 90s era. Big man, you're making a schoolboy era. Step out just to start causing terror. The techno bust out the panty terror. Make man dash if I lift my sweater. Man left his shoe like a Cinderella.
Can I just say, Jay Huss is from East London and that's where we're from. So I'm not just putting it out there.
He's from Newham, though.
I'm from Newham, bro.
He ain't from Hackney.
East is East. Anything that film, East is East, rude boy.
But that's an Asian film.
East is
Big up Asia. But no, because no, do you know what it is? No, I'm not having it.
What, because you're from North West?
I'm from North West London, and I let my... I let my man from other boroughs be themselves. Don't claim the whole of East. Because when man from Newham are doing all kind of funny things, you're not trying to have it from them. That's I've seen you do that. No, don't.
No.
Hus, you ain't related to them. Related to me, dog.
Brother.
I mean, there's from Jamaica.
Shut in that.
It's home.
I just wanted to say, like, he's an East Londoner.
And we're from East.
And he's flying the flag.
Okay. I just wanted everybody to know, me and Tricky are from East, and Hus is from East.
They call it a purple patch in football, where a man just, anytime you see his name in the starting lineup, you know he's going to lick a goal or two. And that's Jay Hus at the moment. If you see his name on a tune or in a festival lineup or in a... You know what time it is.
You the one that I want, okay. Yeah, me now, you saying know, that, you know. You know how you said the song before was probably your least favourite so far out of the High Calibre? This is probably mine. And I wanted what Hema wanted as well. Like that kind
but
of
did
that.
Did it happen though?
Not for that this. This it, one did, yeah, but I think the hook was a little bit weak. I think there was too much distortion in the sound as well. Like it wasn't that old school Hus that gives you that kind of grease. It was just a bit.
I just like the fact that I get to wind my waist. I like to wind on my waist, but we like. Yeah.
I'm not a wind waist and tell her.
That's bush. That's very bush.
But it gave you the change you wanted. No, it didn't give me the change I wanted. No, because I'm talking about. I'm tired of whining now. I'm tired of like enjoying the flow. I'm tired of my hands.
You just want a bush. You want some
I
bush.
Literally just want to get up and just. You know, like what was it? What's the Jay Hus song? Clarting. I'm ready to. Yeah. I'm ready to.
Oh, that tune is so cold.
I needed just more bunda shaking songs that made me want to get up. I had a lot of whining tunes, which are nice, but sometimes just want to lose your mind and just twerk from here to here, you know? But, you know, the thing is, he could deliver if he wanted to. He obviously just wasn't there at the time, but please give us some more. Do like a big conspiracy part two where it's just bunda shaking rhythms, because then we'll all be satisfied.
We're coming like the military. A thousand bells coming like a tooth fairy. See you getting clapped up, I'm coming like a visionary. Pole looking bloody merry. Hitting anybody near me, my own friends moving wary. Reckless.
Aggressive.
Reckless. Please don't vex us. Reckless. Delete all my texts. Reckless. Girl wants sex us, you know what sex is. Reckless, grab her by the necklace. So much neck, girl gon' need a neck brace. Girl saw my bracelet, now she wanna embrace. I just fuck face and touch base. I'm getting back to the trenches in a rush. Come back to my senses when I bust. Pray my niggas bust case. I got guys doing bootings with a hot face. They're the reason why your estate is not
this
safe.
This must be the change
up
you're looking for,
though. I know what I want, because this song, even though like he's chatting some something, I know I'm going to get my song. It's just not here yet.
I think that was definitely a show of his skill, though. That was skill. Like, you get me? That was talent on the show there.
The song for me doesn't really go anywhere, but there's a lot, like, lyrically to take in, but like at this point I agree with Hema, because it's like I want something else now, because like it's almost like it sounds really bad to say, but everything is such of a good high quality. Everything is so musical, like it's not just like some beat, like there's actually layers, but now it's like it's been so good, it's like I just want something else. I just want old school Jay Hus for like 1 minute.
I want Jay Hus to understand, yeah, this is your fault. Do you get what I'm saying?
No, the bar is so high.
Yes, bro, so and you've set your
That's
bar so high.
That's where it is.
So don't think there's any comparison that other guy can do better. He's out of it. You're competing with yourself, bro. Don't you notice, even Hema saying, you're competing with old Jay Hus and new Jay Hus. Like, ooh, new, old, bam, bam, bam. So he's, you know when people say like, I'm in competition with myself and they're just bullshit. They're bullshitting. Here is the fucking truth. Do you get what I'm saying? Because if I'm putting him up against something, I ain't putting him up against a Stormy or a Dave or this man.
Well done, Chucky. Well done.
Yeah. First round of applause for the listening party.
I like the link up there. I like the link up. That's beautiful.
Do you get what I'm saying? Everybody so just I'm not even going to say no more because I might fuck it up. Because he set the bar so high, the ones that weren't good just weren't good on his plate. But there's a hundred other artists that will put that in their thing. And I'll think for them, it will be dope. But for him, because he set his bar so high, that is meaty.
There's no denying. Army's rising. Call me a titan. Thundery light. Circle tightly. The hustle I dive in. Struggle and striving. My business I'm minding. Don't tell me where your mind
is. I already know I'm a psychic.
Anytime it's a crisis. We're the strongest and the wisest. Free all my life. Rise up your lighters, before you fully rise up.
We have to remove the virus.
ain't seen nothing like this. Juju J in life flesh. You know me, I'm the livest. Call on all your riders. Call on all your strikers. Me, I don't even fear death. You don't know me, I'm fearless. Me, I'm out here bare chest. They can't come nowhere near us. They might start moving careless. Clap the man that's nearest.
Oh, it's the first time I heard this tune.
Me, I'm serious. Juju J is my alias. Madman the craziest in a 100-mile radius. My best friend is anonymous. You need a hit man, come and holler us. I'm shaking all your chakras. Gotta stop smoking cannabis. Every day different challenges. Never had worthy challenges. Me and you are different calibers. Every day wake up manifest. Say you shot a man, but I'm not impressed. My new girl is on house arrest.
I stop it. J-Hus, you're a bad boy. And I'm not gonna lie, you know. It should have been stopped. One minute, it should have been stopped a minute ago. Yeah. You've been going on bad.
Oi, can I say something major that you're not going to agree with, yeah? I don't even know if there's an artist on earth that's in his pocket like my man at the moment. Like, there's not a prime like this. This is a golden run, fam. Like, a man made something, he made common sense and just said, I'm just an ultimate man. I'm never going back to normal status, bro. He's too much, fam.
100%. Huss can fly the flag for the UK anywhere in the world. If Martians came down to Earth and was like, yo, what's popping over here, like, musically wise, like, who's doing their thing? We can run Huss's stuff, make it represent Earth. That's how I feel. So it's not even just like a UK or an American thing, like, just like universally, like, I think he's cold once you start getting into the music. The way he bads up features and stuff, the elements and like what he brings to other people's songs sometimes, it's like, it's too much.
He don't care if he like, he's not talking your reality or if he's not like reaching you. Yeah. He doesn't give a shit. Like, he'll just talk what he's, like he'll talk his truth.
But he still reaches
and
he'll
take it or, he take it or leave it.
So unapologetic.
Just to finish what she was saying, I have to add, yeah. A couple songs ago, people were anticipating like, right, what's the change or whatever and whatever. Yeah, yeah. But I'm telling you, it's because it's the middle of the project. He did it purposely. Chill, vibe with man. Low, but then he came back with no denying, because there is no denying, J-Hus. I'm sorry, my brother. No denying, you're the hard.
We've had him on them sexy kind of like tunes, and now you've got this almost like drilly like beat.
I think the production is a massive part of the song.
Yeah. Yeah. Bring up TSB on this one, because this production is mad. And I really want us, like, even if you see the way, even the way he says like serious, he won't say serious, he says serious. And it's like he brings us into his own type of lingo. Like, we adopt his shit.
Cool. We're moving on to the next song. Must be.
Can I say something? One tech, sorry to cut you so fast. We've been saying it for years, and there's ways that you can say it, because you've got these drill artists that will say it in such an aggressive way that we don't even get them. That you hang with my man and you better da 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 da. No, that you, if you chill with the up, you will have your dad thinking he's got ups, like. You get, then it must be. I think he's done it so right where there's no, like, we're all smiling saying up, like everyone's got ups in here. And I ain't, like, don't worry about that. Do you get what I'm saying? But the way he's put it out, he's made you so comfortable, like, to where people kind of even forget what they're
no,
even
exactly.
About.
Yeah, he's making normal youths talking about smelling like ups. Appreciate
no,
the
but
team.
With no aggression.
No,
it's
sweet.
They're not
with
going
this.
Out there saying, I've got ups, I'm going to bang on a man.
I'm not
under
saying that.
You're
else,
just like,
man.
So you just walk past your ups like that and cool,
that's
like, all right, cool.
Out of this episode,
I see,
bro.
If you chill with that up.
Edit
you get what
out,
I'm saying?
I'm done.
Hang
I'm
over
done,
there.
Man.
Stay
I'm
over
done.
There. Don't watch that,
Emma,
man. I'm
it's over.
I just feel like it's a grown and mature sound from where he's come from. Common Sense was a great album, and he really just showed us like how to deliver on an album, especially with like J5, and I feel like the same thing's happened again, but I do feel like it's slightly more mature.
It's not like a up, then it must be a up. If it
looks
like
a up,
chill with a up. Hang with a up, then it must be.
Next track is featuring Ella May. It's called One and Only.
You know this is the shit I go hard for.
Alright, cool. Probably the first negative thing, I don't think she went with it. I think she come in here and brought it right down for me.
No, but you don't diss LMA. She made Boot Up. Boot Up, Boot Up.
All right, well, cool.
Yeah, but she didn't come hard on this.
Yeah,
though.
She didn't. I she think didn't, she brought she it didn't. Down. I think she brought it down a bit. What do you lot think?
It was all right, but.
Yes.
No, it doesn't. It's just.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, why don't you, man, get this camera on me? Ella. I'm here for you. I got you.
I know she done booed up and ooed up and ooed up. Do you get what I'm saying? But for this song, I think where I was here on a level with him, soon as she came in, I went like that.
Her tone made it a bit too poppy.
Yeah.
I don't want to hear pop music on this thing. LMA by herself is calm, whatever, but I'm saying like, this on his feature, I would have preferred a more like raspy,
it sounded like the commercial
calmy. It would just became like this is a commercial tune, which is why I said that I would have liked it to stop there because I knew what was coming next.
Out of all the vocalists in the UK, personally, like I would have loved to hear like Tiana Major or someone like that. Do you know what I mean? I feel like it might have been a bit more cohesive. Like I just don't know. Like I'm not necessarily an Ella fan. Like yeah, she's done her thing with.
One thing I've got to say about you women is you got to stop tearing each other down.
Let's go.
Let her go. There's just other singers I think that could have done something else. Like I don't know if
Ella's tone suits this type of song. Do you know what I mean?
I mean, she sounds alright, but like me personally, she's got one of those kind of voices where I'll kind of expect what she's gonna do anyway. I want to ask you,
like, a part of it is it because. For me personally, I haven't really seen. You said the Chipmunk tune. I don't even know that tune. But she doesn't really deal with the UK a lot. And I think Jay Huss is very like flying the flag for UK right now. So would you have preferred someone that's like more
that doesn't really come into it. I'm just thinking literally it's the tone of voice and like her style, like the way she riffs and stuff. I just think there'd be other people that would have had a different tone that just would have added something. Do you know what I mean?
Let me show you two bars. I was the only leg man in the disco. I wanna put it on me. I better. It doesn't go like, yeah, it don't like. Just sometimes just fucking agree.
It's not my favorite song in the world. I ain't gonna lie, like, I ain't really like, I'm not overrating it like that. But at the same time, it's not even a biased thing, but Ella made Booed Up. Booed Up, Booed Up. Buddha, Buddha. So it's like you gotta put a bit of respect on her name. Like, man, are you talking about her? Do you know what I'm trying to say? That's the truth.
You can have a feature with someone I don't know who the fuck they are, but if the person fits well, the song will be great. That's what I'm saying. You don't need to have a big heavyweight name to make the song good. Do you know what I mean?
All right, let's go to the next one because I can't be doing all this tearing down women thing.
Shut up, man.
That was a song that was a late addition. It came out, you know, a week or two later past the album, and hearing it, it wasn't like wow, like. Oh my gosh, we really missed something by not getting that. It didn't do anything for me. I didn't really think it was needed personally.
I love this chorus. You hearing what he's saying? They want to see a gunman and lose my sanity.
You love it, don't you? You feel the energy when you come around it. Girl love me and they scream and they shout it. I'm on this thing and they know I'm about it. I always got the best product on the market. Your forehead
and a bullseye and a target.
Tell them.
I think my man's super wavy, yeah, because I feel like this is a bit of like a filler track. Yeah. But it's still like, it's still wavy, like. I don't know, like, I don't understand.
Yeah. Your fillers are banger.
Your fillers are kind of banging, like, it's mad.
Find me an album of a artist of this prolific like type of level who's making this type of music. There isn't one, because the thing is, around in the UK, there's bare people making music. But at the level that he's at, there's not what other rapper is making music like that right now. There's a lot of people doing it, but it's just they're not at that scale. Do you know what I mean? It's unfortunate, but it's just the way shit goes. Jay Huss has come from like being a bit more hood, and now he's got up here and he's running the music thing. What are you saying to me?
I don't think this is a filler. I think because he's not speaking about. Like, he's talking about love, peace, prosperity. He's talking about, like, his culture, like, how, he, like, just regular things. Like, I'm waiting, I'll shake my hand with, I shake someone's hand with the, like, with my right hand and stuff like that. Like, he's talking about stuff that, like, for me, I can relate to it.
A lot of the music that's around today is good simply for the fact that everyone likes it. But when it comes to Jay Huss, you kind of have to personally subscribe to parts of it that you like the kind of gunman thing. Certain man are gonna like that. The Gyalem thing, certain man are gonna like that. It just shows his versatility as an artist. I think he's amazing, man. Serious.
Cool. Let's move on to the final track of the album, Deeper Than Rap.
This tune's wicked. This tune is wicked.
Hear this tune. Watch when you hear this fucking tune, bro.
This tune is wicked.
He's a bad boy.
No one talk apart from me.
Let him go on this one, please.
I don't wanna make friends, I don't wanna break the ice. I think about my life and I analyze. The gunman was aiming at me, but he weren't precise. I looked down the barrel of the gun and saw paradise.
We, I beg you, reel him, please. Can you reel him, please? No, because you don't get that. Yeah. Niggas is going through real things. Yeah. Real things. Even as a millionaire, he's saying, you know what? Mazza. That's what I love. No, because certain men get jewels and grills and forget about all the emotions that got us to where we are now, you understand? And for me, I appreciate that so much.
Lippy,
it's so hard.
Hearing you on that like top of that track sounded like you should have had an intro. Yeah.
Do you
know what? You should have been on the intro.
Bring me.
I was thinking that, you know? I was thinking that.
I'm just saying. Is that like a pasta? No. Like a little one to
nah, it's just,
away.
Nah, seriously.
And Jay Huss will come raining down. Guys,
no, it is.
The project definitely has replay value, 100%. It is a very good, solid album.
All I need is some mash and a corner and a cob. I was chilling with Chanel, but I called her a cab. I'm so on my job that I sleep in the lab. You think I go without a fight, but I think that you're mad. I knew they was coming, so I sat and waited. They tried burst through the door, but it was barricaded. I wasn't lost in the sauce, but I was marinated. We looked at the stars and then we navigated. We started thinking as one, then we elevated. We never said a word, we just demonstrated. No blacks, no dogs, we were segregated. They took our history, then they went and erased it.
Stop, one sec. Mo, hey, what I'm telling you? Any points that I was gonna dock off this album, yeah. I just bring them right back up again.
I genuinely believe there's not an artist on the planet right now that is just in their bag the way Huss is.
I'm just a roadman, so why am I preaching? God made you sexy, so why are you bleaching? How you send your son to school and don't know what they teach him? How you be for next
hug your black and you don't know the reason? Like, I got you me, for that.
How you send your son to school and don't know what they teach him?
Why they wanna kill us for natural resources? Every move that you make, you have to be cautious. I work with the powers, I work with the forces.
Obviously, it's not a secret listening party. We've been away for a little while. Big Conspiracy come out a little while ago, so this was a project that I've kind of had time to take in and digest. I'm sure you see me dancing and singing along to most of the tunes. Jay Huss is just a monster for me, man.
I had to play dumb just to blend in, then go to Africa for spiritual cleansing.
Stop it. Yeah.
I just want to say something. I don't even want to say nothing, man. Let me not talk, man.
Thought I would never give an album a 10 out of 10, but this project, I'm rating it 10 out of 10, purely for the content, the intelligence, and the growth is literally mind-blowing. I love to see music like this because it reflects and it also inspires people.
I think the levels he set, what he spoke about, there's so many different things, like I've heard it once, but hearing something once and getting the feel that I've got, I want to give him 17 if the people behind the camera will let me give a man 17 out of 10. But because we can't do 17 out of 10, it's a straight 10 out of 10.
I've been saving my 10 for Jay Huss just because what he is what we needed, and it's very separate to everyone else. And you're a great example for a lot of people coming up in this music thing. I'm gonna give you a 10 out of 10. Not saying that all the songs I love, because I would have loved one more bunda shaking something, please. Like, there's something that made me gonna get up and clap a little something. But apart from that, you're amazing. You're my favourite of all time. You're the GOAT, and I'll always give you my 10. So yeah, man, good for you.
I'm gonna say something else. So I'll always give you my crutches whenever, Jay.
No. But then also like the way the things he's speaking about in his tweets and whatever also reflects what he's saying in his music. So it's like it's a good reflection of where he is at the moment. You mentioned the Moors. You say, you know, your skin is whatever. So why are you bleaching? I'm just there like yeah.
Before now, I thought Common Sense was a lot better than this, but after hearing it in this environment, a little bit of juice in me as well, I don't know, man, because some of the messages in this were serious, so I can't give it less than a 10, man. Shit. Nah, seriously, I didn't know I'd give it a 10, but I can't do what I was doing and not give it a 10. I was in the video for about 7 of them tunes. So yeah, nah, frightening talent, 10 out of 10, wow. Reckless, aggressive.
I'm really happy that we did this episode. It's definitely a 9 out of 10 for me. It's not going to be a 10 just because what I listen to on a day-to-day basis, this doesn't fulfill that. But I can't take away from your talent, and I cannot take away from the message. I do feel like
these kind of messages I could get from somebody else, but it's not going to be something I enjoy. It's going to be too conscious. It's going to go over my head. I'm not going to enjoy the music. Like, you still got the crud in there as well. So you painted a real picture. I feel like you really gave us the best of you. And yeah, you're sick.
I'm going to give this project 9 out of 10. And yeah, I'm giving it a 9 out of 10.
I'm not rushing, I'm not trying to sway you.
Don't rush me. I'm a big man, I'll do what I want, yeah? I'm giving it a 9 out of 10, and it's kind of like what Yuzo was saying before. Huss is in his own league. I feel like Huss is the GOAT. East Side Business. Yeah.
We get it.
I'm sorry, I just like the hoodie. I like, it's a good hoodie. Where you get it from?
It's Nike. I'm saying, I feel like Huss is the GOAT. I feel like East London got the best rappers, and I feel like you're flying the flag for all of us. Gang shit. I'm giving it a 9 out of 10, because like these men were saying before, I'm kind of holding you up against yourself, and Common Sense is a classic top, it's a top thing, and I don't think this is better than Common Sense. So I'm giving it a 9, but I think it's dope.
Good reason.
I think it's super dope, and I really enjoyed it, and I like the project, and I'm going to listen to it again and again, but it's not better than Common Sense. Common Sense is classic UK album. That's a 10 for me, and this is just a little notch below. So I'm giving it a 9 out of 10.
All right, cool. So we have given this album, J Huss's Big Conspiracy, a 9.5 out of 10.
Very close.
Big up, bro. Big up, big up, big up, big up.